Welcome you all to this course. I'll start with the syllabus followed by a brief overview of different type of signals starting from the analog to digital signals. This lecture will help you to understand the process behind the conversion from analog to digital data and why we should study analog circuit and signals where everything is being digitized. The first type comes in the list is the analog signal itself, which has a technical name, the continuous in time and continuous in amplitude signal, or CTCA. The next from the lot is DTCA, followed by the DTDA, and the last thing is the digital signal. So, let's start. The first book that I advise to my student always to start with is this one, Electronics Devices and Circuits by Robert Boylestad and Louis Nesselsky. However, the next book is Fundamental of Microelectronics by Razavi. This book is also a very good book and any student can start with this book also. But I do always prefer to start with this book, and that is why I advise to my student. Anyway, the second book is also a very nice book and very good book to start with. The third book is by Cedra and Smith. This one is very good, very nice book, covered almost everything in analog electronic circuits. But I don't advise to my student to read this book at the first time. However, you can read with this book. They have covered everything in details, so you can also go with this book also. But this book, Integrated Electronic Circuit by Milman and Helkias, this you can consider as a reference book, and don't start your study from this book because this is a reference book. Once you have the basic concepts by studying any one of these previous three books, then you can go with this fourth book. But don't start your study from this fourth book. But however, this book is very nice and very good, and there are some topics where I will refer this book also, and those topics you can consult with this book. Let's start with the first one, that is continuous in time and continuous in amplitude signal, or CTCA. This is the technical name of pure analog signal. This is the signal our mother nature speaks with. All around us are analog in nature. When you speak to your family, speak to your parents, to your friends, or you listen to them, all of you are speaking with analog signals. Therefore, what an analog signal means? By definition, for an analog signal, there exist an infinite number of data points between two successive data points. Or more precisely, you can say, within any arbitrary time interval, the number of points between two successive points in amplitude are infinite with any arbitrary precision. What does that mean? That means it is no matter how many times you zoom in a section from the amplitude, you will never find two such points in amplitude having no other points between them. Every time there will be a set of infinite data points between any two of them. Take an example as I have shown over here. Here I have drawn a sample analog signal. Here, if I consider a time interval, any arbitrary time interval on that with the time axis, so if you zoom in this section within this time interval, you will never reach such a points where two consecutive points are distinguishable, or there exists no any other points between two consecutive points. You will never reach such a point. So this is a example of the analog signal. Thus, since any analog signal or any analog device required to process the infinite number of data points for an analog signal, so obviously the analog devices are slow in time. Therefore, we need to move on to get the faster ones. From our school level physics, we know that if a set of pictures or set of still pictures runs in front of our eyes more than 10 times per second, so we cannot distinguish each and every picture separately. And that is the idea behind movies. And similarly, so this is basically the limitation of our eyes, what we are seeing. And similarly, our ears also has such kind of limitations. So what does that mean? That means for our purpose, it is not necessary to process all those analog or all those infinite number of points what exist in analog signal. It is enough to get a few samples out of them. The discrete in time and continuous in amplitude signal is that kind of signal. So discrete in time means the time axis has been discretized, or as I have shown over here, I have taken a sample from the previous signal. The previous signal was the analog signal, and here I have represented that same signal but a sample of them. So the sampling frequency I have used is 15 kilohertz. Similarly, you can sample with more frequency like this one. Here I have sampled the initial analog signal by 150 kilohertz. So the sampling means you are representing all those data points but with a discrete time intervals. So here I am taking the time intervals. So within this time interval, this amplitude exists. But the name discrete in time and continuous in amplitude means within these time intervals, this amplitude remains continuous again. However, between the previous time interval, there exists no, these amplitudes are absent, but in the negative axis, this amplitude do exist. And this amplitude also contains infinite number of points within that particular interval. But however, the data points are even less than the previous one, or the actual, in comparison to the actual analog signal, because we are not considering all the times every time. So this is the example of discrete in time and continuous in amplitude. And here I have obtained this signal by simply multiplying one square wave pulses with the original analog signal. The next one is the discrete in time and discrete in amplitude signals, or DTDA signal. In such type of signals, the amplitude is also discretized along with its time. That means if you consider this signal with the previous signal, that means discrete in time and continuous in amplitude signal, just I told you. So if you compare these two signals, you will see that in the previous signal, there was infinite number of data points within any given interval. But here, those data points are shrink to a particular data point. So for any given interval, there exists only a single data point. So that is why the top or bottom level are appearing flat for this kind of signal, for DTDA signals. That means whatever was the amplitude in the previous case, right now we are not considering all of them, we are just considering any one of them, preferably the middle one. The discretization in amplitudes is clearly visible in this diagram. These are the levels at which the amplitudes are discretized. That means initially, with respect to the discrete in time and continuous in amplitude signal, we have seen that the amplitude levels or the data points exist in amplitude was infinite for any given interval. Although the time interval has been discretized in that case also, but the amplitude levels was distributed infinitely within any given interval. But here, in order to avoid all those amplitude levels, I have considered that there are certain levels. If the amplitude falls within that levels, we are considering that all the amplitudes are equals to that particular level. Say for example, within this interval, Initially, the amplitudes were distributed infinitely around 1.0, and I am considering right now that is equals to 1.0. Similarly, within this interval, the amplitude was distributed around 0.625, and I am not now considering this amplitude as 0.625 instead of all considering all those amplitude points. In this way, I have discretized the entire amplitude level or the range of amplitudes in several levels. The levels, each levels are called quantization level, and the process is known as the quantization. And each level of amplitude is known as the quantization level. The difference between each levels is known as the steps in quantizations. So that means the time axis is discretized by sampling them, and the sampling frequency is 15 kilohertz, and the amplitude axis is quantized or discretized by quantization with some discrete levels, and the discrete levels I have considered here, that is 8. In this diagram, I have superimposed the previously obtained discrete in time and continuous in amplitude signal over the discrete in time and discrete in amplitude signal. The red dotted ones represents the discrete in time continuous in amplitude, because look, within any interval the amplitude is continuous over there for the red ones, and the blue ones represents the discrete in time and discrete in amplitude signals. Now, comparing these two signals, we can clearly identify that although for the discrete in time and continuous in amplitude signal, the amplitude was continuous within any specific interval, for the discrete in time discrete in amplitude signal, the amplitude is also quantized or discretized to certain levels. So this is the one level, this is one level, as I just told. But such kind of discretization introduce certain errors. So this is the errors. Actual data points exist within this range. However, we are assuming the data points is around this range. So this is the quantization error. Similarly over here. And such type of quantization error increases with higher sampling time if the quantization level remains smaller and sampling time remains higher. Take an example. Now consider this one. Here I have sampled by 150 kHz, while the previous one I have sampled with 15 kHz. Although the quantization level I have maintained equal similar to the previous one. In order to mention or in order to show you that the quantization error increases with larger sample, if the quantization level is not increased but the sampling frequency increased, the quantization error also gets increased. This error can be visualized clearly if we superimpose the original data over this, like this. The quantization error can be visualized in a better way in this diagram, because I have superimposed the original discrete in time and continuous in amplitude data over this discrete in time and discrete in amplitude data, where the latter signal is sampled by 150 kHz, but the quantization level remains same, that is 8. Look around this portion, or this portion, or here, or here. The low level quantization overestimates the original data points. So initially the original data was around this level, but the low level quantization is overestimating the value of original data point, and the error is much more prominent over here. This level was around 0, but the low level quantization is estimating the value around 0 by such a high level, like this. So this quantization error is so large for a low level quantization and high level sampling. Now check this one. Here I have used the sampling frequency as 15 kHz and the quantization level I have increased to 256 instead of using 8 that I have considered in my last slide. Look at this quantization error. Here, the discrete amplitude levels are closely following the original amplitude levels of the discrete in time and continuous in amplitude signals. If we zoom in any of this time period, say for example this interval, if we zoom in, we can visualize the reduction of this quantization error in a clear way. Let's take an example. Look at here. This red dotted one was the original continuous amplitude, and these are the discrete levels distributed around the original amplitudes to approximately follow these amplitude levels. So therefore, since the quantization level is higher in comparison to the previous one, this amplitude, the quantization error reduces in a greater way in comparison to the previous one, where the quantization level I have considered only 8. Along with that, obviously I have to explain it with a higher sampling rate. So take the example of the higher sampling rate, where sampling frequency is 150 kHz and quantization level is 256. And here also the amplitudes are not overestimating the original amplitudes. Here they are following the original amplitudes. And if we zoom in any portion of that, so suppose here, because previously we have seen that the low level quantization was overestimating the amplitude in a greater extent at this portion, so I have considered to show you how closely the higher level of this quantization is following the original amplitude. So let's zoom in this particular portion. Look at this diagram. Here you can see that how closely the quantization level is following the original amplitude. So that means the more quantization level, the better precision you can obtain in discretization of the amplitude levels. So if the sampling is done in a larger, is using a larger frequency as shown over here, 150 kHz, which is very large in comparison to the original signal, if the sampling frequency is larger, the lower quantization level will introduce a higher quantization error, whereas the higher quantization levels will reduce that quantization error. But however, how much the quantization level will increase, there will be a certain amount of quantization error, because you are getting a discrete version of the original analog data. Although I have discretized the entire range of the amplitude for the analog signal, the values at each level are still analog in nature. Say for example 1.0, 0.625, 0.375, all such values are still analog in nature. Therefore, to obtain the digital signal from this analog data, we need to represent each of these quantization levels by some binary numbers. So in order to do that, we first need to know how many levels I have used in my quantization. Here I have considered the 8 levels to make this explanation simpler. Since 8 levels can be represented by only 3 bits, that is why I have represented each level of amplitude by 3 bits. For example, 001 is representing 0.125 in my scheme, and 010 is representing 0.375 in my scheme. You may design your particular scheme where the quantization level will be represented by some different kind of or different sets of binary numbers. That is up to you. However, since the 8 levels can be represented by only 3 bits, so say and these 8 levels are representing the magnitude parts, so these 3 bits can only represent the magnitude part. What about the sign part? For the sign part, we need additional bits. So here I have considered the additional bit for the sign part, where zeros are representing the positive sign while the ones are representing the negative sign. Now take an example of forming the digital signal. In this slide, I will show you the generation of digital signal. Previously, we have seen that from the quantized level, we can generate the binary numbers, or we can encode each of the quantization level by some binary numbers as shown over here. But these binary numbers are not the digital signals, because the signals means some level of voltage or current. So when the sequence of binary numbers will be represented by some voltage level, then that signal will be called as digital signal. For example, suppose a 0 bit is represented by minus 5 volt and one bit will be represented by plus 5 volt. Or depending upon your technology what you are using, that 0 volt may be represented by a 0 volt or minus 1 volt, that and 1 bit may be represented by plus 1 volt or 0 volt. That may depend upon your technology what you are using for processing the digital signal. So once such kind of conversion from binary to the voltage level is done, so that signal will be called the digital signal. Consider this part, which is marked by green lines. Take an example that starting from this value, the signal is being fed to a communication channel or to a device in such a way that as time elapses, the voltage level from 0.125 to minus 0.125 and next to next to next and going back to its initial position. So this is the entire voltage level is going to feed the particular communication channel or a particular device. Now how the sequence of binary numbers will be represented by voltage level and they will be forwarded to be fed into that channel or that device, that I will demonstrate over here. So first voltage level is 0.125, which is corresponding to the binary sequence 0001. The next voltage level will be this one, having the binary sequence 1001. The next one is this, next is this, next is this. So once it reaches this particular point, it is going back to previous one. So after reaching this sequence, it will go back to the previous one. Next this and next this, in this way. Now we will see when these sequences will be represented by some voltage level, how the digital signal forms and how it is forwarded. So these are the bit sequences. The first sequence is 0001 corresponding to this one. Next one is 1001, this one. Next one is 1010, which is this. Next one is 1011, this one. And the last one is 1100. And after that, it will be repeated again. So first one is this bit. When this appear at the input terminal of the communication channel of the device and it will be represented by some voltage level, here I am considering that zeros are being represented by some positive volt while ones are being represented by some negative volt. The level of the positive voltage and the level of the negative voltage depend upon the technology what you are using. So since three zeros are there, they will maintain the same voltage level. So this is a positive voltage level. So after having 000, there is a 1. So there must be a change to or switch to take place. So it will switch to the negative voltage level, which represents the 1. But after this 1, there is another 1 appears from this 1. So next level, since this next level is this 1. So the low voltage level will continue up to the next one, and after that again 200 is appearing from the second sequence, so it will go back to the positive voltage level, and then again two consecutive ones from this one and from the next one. So like this, so it will go to the next voltage level or the low voltage level, which will represent the 1 1. So this one and this one, and after that 0 1 0 1. So we'll expect to get it from 0 to 1 and 1 to 0 and 0 to 1. So like this. So the alternating bits will be represented by alternating voltages. Now after that, the next sequence is 1 1 0 0. But considering the previous bit sequence, there are 1 1 1 1 4 1. So it will maintain the low voltage level to represent all these 4 ones, and the next is 0 0. After this point, as I have explained in my last slide, that it will turn to go to the upward direction. That means one after 1100, the next bit sequence will appear, that is 1011. So 1011. So this bit will continue from here. So since 00 was the last bit what we have seen from here, so that will be continued and it will face 1. So I have placed a dotted line to represent that it is coming from this 00. So after 00, since it is 1011, so there is a low voltage level, there is a high voltage level, there is 3 voltage level to represent the consecutive ones. Then next this, next the bit sequence is this one, and that will be this, and next the bit sequence will be this one, and that will be represented by this one. Now since these ones and zero are now been represented by some voltage level, maybe higher voltage or lower voltage to represent these logical high value and logical low values, these are the digital signals. Let's summarize today's lecture. First, I have defined the analog signal, which is technically a continuous in time and continuous in amplitude signal, where the amplitude contains infinite number of data points within a particular interval. But for our use, such kind of details exist in an analog data is not necessary. So that is why I have taken some sample out of the analog data. So that procedure produces another signal which is called discrete in time and continuous in amplitude signal. But in this signal, the amplitude is still analog within a particular interval. So that is why we need to discretize the amplitude level also, and that has been done by the quantization. And quantization means the assignment of a range of amplitude within a particular interval to a particular fixed analog values. But the quantization level, the values of the quantization level are still analog in nature. So therefore, to construct the digital signal, we need to convert these analog values or the fixed analog values into some binary sequences. And once you have obtained the binary sequence, then those binary sequences can be represented by some voltage levels, or each bit can be represented by some voltage level. So once you are done with that, you can obtain, or you are done with the digital signal. And this, the entire process, the conversion from the analog to digital signal, is done using a particular special type of device, and that is called the analog to digital converter or A2D converter. The entire process is maintained within a particular device, and the voltage level what you are using, that is maybe plus 1, minus 1, 0, plus 1, 0, minus 1, which may represent the high voltage and low voltage, that depends upon the technology based on which your analog A2D converter is designed. So that's all for today.